The image of her friends now faded from the magic picture, and the old landscape slowly reappeared. Ozma was thinking of the time when, with Dorothy and her army, she marched to the Nome King's underground cavern beyond the Land of Ev, and forced the old monarch to liberate his captives, who belonged to the royal family of Ev. That was the time when the Scarecrow nearly frightened the Nome King into fits by throwing one of Billina's eggs at him, and Dorothy had captured King Roquat's magic belt and brought it away with her to the Land of Oz. The pretty princess smiled at the recollection of this adventure, and then she wondered what had become of the Nome King since then. Merely because she was curious and had nothing better to do, Ozma glanced at the magic picture and wished to see in it the King of the Nomes. Roquat the Red went every day into his tunnel to see how the work was getting along and to hurry his workmen as much as possible. He was there now, and Ozma saw him plainly in the magic picture. She saw the underground tunnel reaching far underneath the deadly desert which separated the Land of Oz from the mountains beneath which the Nome King had his extensive caverns. She saw that the tunnel was being made in the direction of the Emerald City and knew at once it was being dug so that the army of gnomes could march through it and attack her own beautiful and peaceful country. "I suppose King Roquat is planning revenge against us," she said musingly, "and thinks he can surprise us and make us his captives and slaves. How sad it is that anyone can have such wicked thoughts! But I must not blame King Roquat too severely, for he is a gnome, and his nature is not so gentle as my own."